man?
Good, man. How are you?
Not too bad. So, you know, we got to start with the obvious. Last year, you know, you tore your ACL in November. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to make you rehash that process, but just to go through less so the physical, but the mental aspect, how big of a challenge has it been for you to start trusting your body again and trusting that knee to hold up when you make your cuts?
Yeah, I think probably the first month or two when I started to be able to come out to the court, that was the hardest. So like in July, mm-hmm. June, July, that was probably the hardest part. But once I felt healthy, it wasn't that much of a big deal. The most tough part mentally was just probably right after surgery. Like I couldn't really walk, couldn't really run. That was the hardest part, just trying to get back, taking those first steps. But I felt like once I got on the court, it was just going to be basketball as normal. And it's kind of been that way. Obviously, there's some aches and some pains, but for the most part, I feel pretty good out there. And I'm just excited that I'm able to play again. I'm really fortunate.
Do you think now that you're back and healthy, that that process, whether it's something you did mentally or physically, has given you anything new to bring to your approach to the game, or you've changed, whether it's an eating habit or you just the approach you've taken being day by day?
Yeah, I think definitely just it puts things into perspective when you get to sit out and watch it from the sideline. You kind of just the game takes kind of a smaller role in your life and you get to look at other things, but mm-hmm. I still feel on the court, you know, I just try to focus on my nutrition a lot, try to drop some pounds, gain some muscle, mm-hmm. And then just focus on specific aspects of my game that I was going to work on anyways, mm-hmm. coming into my senior year, but fortunately I have another year. Mm-hmm. But just trying to slow the game down even more, work on some different finishes, some different shots. So mm-hmm. I definitely had a lot of time to, you know, do that kind of stuff, and I feel like it's going well so far.
Like you said, is there any one part of your game that specifically that you're really trying to maybe bring this year that we didn't see first freshman sophomore year?
Yeah, I think I'm trying to work on handling the ball and getting to my shot more off the dribble. Mm-hmm. I think that's something I can help bring to the table. We have a lot of guys that can create, and the ability to make quick moves off the dribble and not necessarily be as methodical, but get to your shot in one or two dribbles is something that I really focused on this summer. You got guys like Gilly and Blake and Grant that can really pass. So I'm just trying to be able to make their job as easy as possible. It's been something I really wanted to focus on.
Mm-hmm. You're 6'4", you know, you're a good shooter. You said you're trying to work on ball handling. What kind of a player do you consider yourself?
I consider myself somebody who can do everything. There's been times I've had to play guard. There's been times where I've been forward. As a freshman, I was the backup center. So, you know, whatever the team needs, I think that's something that I view as a strength of mine. Some people might see that as confusing, but I view that as a strength, forcing the way we play, the way that Coach Manny has us play. All the guys can do everything. He gives us the freedom to do everything out on the court. We all play a little bit of every position. So I'm not really too worried about what I'm listed. I just want to go out there and play and help my team win.
So your freshman year, you had a pretty significant role for a freshman, about 20 minutes a game. Then that sophomore year, you really make that big leap. And then you have the momentum going into last year. It ends early. How important is it to you to pick up, you know, right where you left off, keep making that next jump? Or is it more, you know, you have 2 years, I have time, I'm going to take my time and find my rhythm?
I'm not going to look at it as taking my time. I think that, you know, there's a sense of urgency around the program as if we have a chance to have a good year this year, have a good year next year, if that's what it comes down to. But I think that's probably been an issue of mine starting off the season pretty slow. My first game has never been as good as I wanted it to be just because the nerves and all that stuff. So I'm trying to come out here and be as aggressive as possible within the confines of the offense. But, you know, I'm just trying to go out there and help my team win, whether it's scoring, like I had done in the past, whether it's rebounding, whether it's just being a defender, whatever it is that the guys need. I just want to try to get off to a good start so that I can look myself in the mirror when I walk in the locker room and feel like that I help my team win in better ways than I have in the past.
So obviously, you know, them losing you last year is huge for one of the major players. But this year, I think that the roster is a little bit different than last year. It's right. A lot deeper. We have, you know, Tyler came in, mm-hmm. Blake's obviously coming in. Pretty much returned the whole team other than Noah and Julius. What about this new roster excites you the most?
I think just the practices are much more competitive. I think that, you know, sometimes in the past, if you don't really think that there's a challenge from the guy behind you in the line, then you're not going to go as hard. I think this year, you know, there's never a off part of practice. Everybody is always going hard, and it's great to see because I think that every day somebody has a good day. It's never, I mean, obviously the guys who are the better players are going to have other good days, but, you know, some days Tyler looks like he's the best forward in practice. Some days it's Nate. Some day Woj has the best day as a guard. You know, that's what excites me the most. I think that there's some we have so much talent that we didn't necessarily have the same way in terms of experience on the court. So I think that's something that I'm really excited about. Just going out there and, you know, when you come out of the game, you're not necessarily worried about the guys going on the floor that maybe they're going to lose the lead, maybe the rhythm's going to go away. You're just focused on getting rest and playing as hard as you can in the minutes because you trust the guys behind you. So that's what I'm really excited about.
So this year, the A10 Talk blog ranked you, Gilly, and Grant all in the top 15 in the conference. So that's pretty high expectations. You know, what are your expectations for this team this year?
I just want to come out and win a lot of games. I don't necessarily want to put a specific goal out there in terms of we're going to win the league. Obviously, everybody Everybody wants to win the league when they lace them up every night. So that's obvious goal. But I think the approach for us, just because of the way the last 2 years, I think that one of the problems that we had is we probably set our expectations a little bit too high and we didn't put the work in before. I think we've put the work in this year, but you know, we've got off to slow starts every single year. So I think it's better for us to say, hey, look, non-conference, we have 4 games before we go to Barclays. Let's try to win all 4. Go to Barclays, let's win those 2. You know, just take it step by step instead of saying, hey, let's go win the conference. Let's be ranked by the end of the season. I think those are things that they're going to happen naturally if we take care of the stuff that we're supposed to do every day. So I know for us specifically, we got to win the first game. That's important. We haven't had a good start. Even when we won my freshman year, it wasn't the best game. So I think instead of saying, hey, we may have these super big goals about making tournaments and stuff like that, I think it's better if we just say, hey, we got 4 games before we go to Barclays. Let's attack these 4 games and go from there. And then after that, you know, everything else will fall into place if we do those things.
So this year, you know, knowing that this is a really strong group coming together, it's a lot deeper. But also knowing that while you guys are more experienced than last year, everyone's coming back next year. What does that mean to you or other players in your approach, just knowing that this group's going to be together for a few years?
I'm not sure. I think that it's easy to kind of have that's like a security blanket, but you never know. Everything's different. The landscape of college basketball is so different. You never know what can happen day to day. So I think we're just looking forward to this year. Next year, that'll be there no matter what. You know, there's always going to be a next year. But right now, we think we're going to be a really good team now. I think that a lot of the talk around us is that we're going to be good this year, but we're going to be even better next year. I look at it as, well, why can't we be that good this year? So just trying to put all of our focus into that. Obviously, if we have a chance to bring everybody back, that would be awesome. And we have a chance to have a really special team. But I think if the same guys come back, if we're as talented as we think we are, we can have a really good year this year.
So like you said, you know, there still is obviously the sense of urgency that it's, you know, even though their expectations are high, you guys still do want to win. But at the same time, it is a pretty new team.
Right.
How do you as a leader tell whether it's the younger guys on the team, you know, if you don't get to a hot start in November, listen, it's a new group, keeping it together, keep grinding. How do you convey that message?
I think we just speak from experience. I think that we have the unique perspective of that. We've had some struggles in November pretty much since I've been here. So obviously you want things to go well, but the way college basketball is, everybody's good. Everybody's working just as hard as you are. It's not always going to be as easy as you think it is. So we're just going to come out here and just try to play as hard as we can. And that's going to be the message to all the new guys that are going to play new roles, going to play more minutes, all that stuff. Yeah, there's a lot of ups and downs in college basketball, but at the end of the day, if you put in the work that you can, then it's going to turn out the way that you want it to.
So you grew up here in Richmond. Your grandfather played at BCU. Your dad played up in Nova at ODU. And you played here at St. Christopher's, right?
Yep.
So what do you think, how do you think your experience has been as a college player here at Richmond versus some of your teammates where they might have grown up in, you know, Woj from California, Sal from New York? How do you think it's made your experience different?
I think it's just a sense of comfort. You know, my high school's middle school is 1 mile up the road. My parents are a short drive away. My grandparents are a short drive away. So I think it's just the comfort that when you can look up in the stands at every game, you see somebody you know, somebody that's been supporting you for a long time. And like I said, just little stuff like, I get to go watch my sister play volleyball. My brother's right up the road. I get to see it every day. My other sister, she's growing up as well. She's getting ready to go to college. That's the cool stuff. Like, I just saw my grandpa today. He dropped off some stuff for me. Like, that's what makes it cool, that I'm fortunate that I have that stuff, as opposed to people who come from other places that may need to, their parents may need to take a 2-day vacation to come down here. My parents are right up the road. I can get a home cooked meal anytime I want. So I think that's made the transition a lot easier for me, and I haven't had to worry about, you know, where I fit in as much, because I always know that I can go home if I'm uncomfortable.
At the same time, with those comforts, you know, there can be distractions, you know, right, pressures of people that watch you in high school but now here again. Have you ever felt any of that, or have you pretty much just, you know, put on the Murphy blinds and block that out?
I think a little bit when I first got here, because I think there was a lot of expectations, just because, you know, you got a guy that came from Richmond and then you had a pretty good high school career, and then people think that it's going to be seamless. But I think that once I realized that it wasn't going to be that easy, the pressure kind of removed itself. I didn't feel that same weight on my shoulder because I realized that it's not always going to be the same route for everybody, and it's not going to be as easy as it was in high school, and my journey is going to be different than everybody else's. But I still feel like I can be successful, and even though that maybe the freshman year didn't start off with the way I wanted to necessarily, it ended up pretty well. And I feel comfortable that, you know, that the pressure is gone, because then I'm just going to play basketball the way I want to, and that the results are going to speak for themselves.
All right, a little bit on a lighter note, since, you know, you probably know best than anybody, you grew up here, give me your 3 best spots to eat here in Richmond. Near campus.
I'm going to say Mama J's. I love Mama J's. There's this place right up the road called The Tavern. My family and I go there a lot. And then I'm probably going to say, Croker's spot is a pretty good spot too. Mm-hmm.
So kind of speaking of diet, you know, we touched on a little bit earlier, but like you said, you know, during your rehab, it's a lot, especially with lower body injury, you know, it's a lot harder to get cardio in. So how much did nutrition and diet really become a point of emphasis for you, and did it change anything that you were doing before?
Yeah, it became a big point of emphasis. I think that naturally post-surgery, you put on a little weight because you're not really doing anything. But I know that Jay, the strength coach, and Adam, the trainer, really sat down and put the plan together as soon as I could start doing stuff. And even when I was just sitting laying in your bed, hey, this is what you have to do. If you want to get to the weight that you want to get to, you want to be the player that you want to be for the next 2 years, then you have to, you know, change yourself. So not as much going out to eat as much, not as much fried food, the D-Hall, all that stuff. Just trying to, yeah, exactly. Yeah. No cellar. I haven't been to the cellar in a while. Just eating more healthy, be more conscious of what I'm eating and not necessarily cutting everything out. Mm-hmm. I think I'll be miserable, but just trying to, you know, be more conscious and make sure that what I'm eating is going to benefit me on the court.
So both with nutrition and fitness, how much do you think that the new facility is going to add next year and helping you guys, you know, keep your body right?
I think it's going to be great. I'm really excited for it. I'm happy. That's one of the things about getting next year is that I get to actually take advantage of that. I think that it's going to be pretty cool to see all the new the gadgets and all that stuff in the new weight room and all that stuff. That's going to be really cool. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to help us. I think it's going to take our program, not just our team next year, but our program in general to another level. And I think it's going to be great for the future of the program.
You kind of touched on there at the end, but so say, you know, if you went back to high school, you were a senior, as a recruit, and you know, you come in, you see on, whether it's on social media, a facility like that being built, how much, obviously it looks great and it looks cool, but how much does that really, like, you see that, is that going to affect recruits' decisions? Do you think that's going to draw in more talent?
Yeah, I think so. I think that anytime you see a shiny new facility up, it's going to naturally bring some interest to the program. Anytime you feel like you can have your own gym, I think that's one of the things that has been a little stressful sometimes, getting court time as much as you want to with the Robin Center, and then there's a graduation, there's a program here, you can't use it. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the Weinstein Center is not always easy to get into and get a court. Now you have a practice gym, and there's going to be no excuses for guys to get better and stuff like that. I think that in terms of just player development and a lot of stuff, we have a chance to be really, really, really good, because anytime you have a practice court, I think we are going to do a really good job developing players, but you know, the practice gym, having your own space, is going to really take it to a whole new level.
All right, so lastly, we're going to do some superlatives with your teammates. This is going to be rapid fire, not much deliberation. I'm just going to ask you a question, answer. You cool. Ready?
Yep.
All right, first, best shoe closet on the team?
I'll say Blake.
Blake?
Yeah.
Worst hair?
Wojcik.
Wojcik?
Yeah.
Okay. I've heard murmurs of Gabe, but I don't know.
Wow, I was going to say Gabe. I was also going to say Gately. Actually, I'm going to change it to Gately.
Gately?
I think he, you know, he thinks he has the best hair, but he doesn't.
All right, most likely to coach at some point in their career?
I'll probably say Gately again.
Gately?
Yep.
Strongest Ox game?
Well, I won the best locker room DJ last year at the Spideys. Okay. So I'm an award-winning DJ.
Award-winning?
Know that, so I would say myself, but other than me, probably Gately.
Gilly, what kind of music you guys playing?
Depends on the mood, honestly. A lot of hip hop, but you know, sometimes after Saturday practice, you want to hear some R&B, stuff like that. Just whatever the vibe is, that's what you go with.
You get a chance to listen to Jesus Is King.
Yeah,
what do you think of it?
Loved it.
Loved it.
I thought it was awesome.
All right, last one. Most likely to take a charge in a pickup game.
I'm gonna say, I'm gonna say Sullivan by accident. Sullivan by accident.
He's a little clumsy.
Yeah, a little clumsy. Somebody's gonna run into him.
Nick, appreciate it, man. Yeah, have a good luck this year.
Appreciate it. Peace on the way, babe, I'm trying to lay, 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 day, ay, I bought a bouquet of the tree fire, and I'm feeling like